Good evening, I'm Nicholas Hoare. It's a great delight to welcome a book on Africa and its stunning nature after a long hiatus. One goes back to books such as Born Free, which incidentally was published by my sister's godfather, Sir William Collins, but not to name drop, the latest in a long, long line of splendid books on this subject has just come out. It's entitled An African Love Story, and it's by a remarkably durable lady called Daphne Sheldrick, Dame Commander of the British Empire, the first such person to be awarded that distinction by Her Majesty the Queen. And with good reason, she's been given this particular recognition for her remarkable work with elephants, specifically baby elephants, and specifically baby elephants that have been abandoned by their parents or who have lost their parents to marauding hunters and are left bereft and alone. Over the years, she's rescued these harmless little delightful and rather cumbersome beasts from a fate worse than death, to mix my metaphors, and turned them around and re-released them into the bush. And she's done it from Nairobi National Park. And she's done it under the auspices of her husband, her late husband's trust, which endowed her work and has kept them going for many a moon. It's a delightful story. It's a love story on the one hand, because she and her husband were devoted to each other and set up this mechanism jointly. And it's also a study of the elephants themselves, all of whom have names, each of whom has character, and many of whom appear in photographs in the book itself. Now, don't be put off by the jacket, which is as bland as a baby's bum. It is, in fact, the proud jacketer, as it were, of a book that is extremely distinguished, very attractive to look at, and riddled with photographs from start to finish. So I'm just going to leaf through and show you some of these remarkable creatures and their caretakers, and it will give you a flavor of what this book is all about. Black and white photography, color photography, history from start to finish, and very much the story of a lady tilting against a windmill. She was the first, and she'll probably be the last, sad to say, but she has carved new territory, and she's saved literally 200 beautiful animals from a very, very sad end. An African Love Story, both of animals and of people, by Dame Daphne Sheldrick, thoroughly and warmly recommended. And on that very animalistic note,